Hey guys, this is T. Welcome to Learn English Canada. Today's lesson will be about the present perfect continuous tense and how to use it in daily conversation. Have you heard about the present perfect continuous tense? You might have if you are an English learner. So why am I saying so? You know, some native English speakers, they even don't know about this tense. They just speak naturally. So I'll give you some examples of using this tense when speaking English a bit later. First, I want you to know the present perfect continuous tense is also called the present perfect progressive tense. The structure of this tense is have or has plus been plus verb ing. For example, I have been teaching English for 2 years. She has been teaching English for 5 years. He has been teaching English for 10 years. Okay? So, when can you use the present perfect continuous tense? We can use this tense to describe a past action that has recently finished, or to describe past actions that are still continuing. Let's look at this example. I am exhausted because I've been exercising for 2 hours. In this case, the action exercising which started in the past is finished. That means I'm not exercising now. Here are some more examples. The grass is wet because it has been raining. I don't understand what the teacher means because I've been sleeping. So, am I sleeping now? No, I am not. But I've been sleeping. Okay? When I want to describe an action that happened in the past but is still continuing in the present, I can use the present perfect continuous tense. For example, I've been teaching English for 3 years. When I say this, I mean I started teaching English 3 years ago and now I'm still teaching English. Okay, let me give you some more examples. I've been cooking for 2 hours. I've been studying since my mom came home. This is a good one. You know, some young people, they want to make their parents happy. So when their parents get home from work, they start reading, doing homework, or reviewing for a test. Have you done this before? Maybe, eh? That's okay to do so. That's okay to show your parents that you are a good student. Okay, now, can you say again? I've been cooking for 2 hours. I've been studying since my mom came home. They've been living in Canada for 7 years. She's been working here since she graduated. Okay, as you can see, I use since and for a lot with the present perfect continuous tense. How can we use for and since with this tense correctly? First, we use for to talk about a period of time, like for 20 minutes, for an hour, for 5 days, for a month, for a year, etc. We use since to talk about a point in the past, like since 10 a.m., since Monday, since November, since 1980, since I left school, since I arrived at work, etc. Okay, so don't take it like just English grammar. You know, we use since and for a lot in speaking English. For example, she has been working for 8 hours. He has been watching movies since I came home. They have been playing soccer for a long time. It has been snowing since midnight. So, since and for are used a lot in daily conversation, right? Sometimes we use conjunctions in informal writing and speaking. So what is a conjunction? A conjunction is a shorter version of some words. You know, instead of saying I have been teaching English for 3 years, I can say I've been teaching English for 3 years. Okay, so this is how we use conjunctions with the present perfect continuous tense. I have been, I've been. She has been, she's been. He has been, he's been. They have been, they've been. We have been, we've been. It has been, it's been. It's not too difficult, is it? So, I've been teaching English since 9 a.m. and you've been watching my video for a while, right? Remember, in negative sentences, we can also use conjunctions. For example, I have not, I haven't. She has not, she hasn't. He has not, he hasn't. So instead of saying I have not been playing guitar for a long time, I can say I haven't been playing guitar for a long time. Is it clear? Sometimes it's confusing because you're not sure whether to use the present perfect tense or the present perfect continuous tense. So don't worry about that. It depends on the speaker's purpose. For example, when I say, "Hi, Mom, I've done my homework," I mean, I finished it already and now I'm not doing my homework. But when I say, "Hi, Mom, I've been doing my homework for an hour," I mean, I started doing my homework and now I'm still doing homework. Okay, does it make sense? So, there are different things to remember when using the present perfect continuous tense. Some of you might think this is easy, some might not. However, don't stress out because we use this tense frequently in daily life. And the more often you practice using this tense in daily conversation, the more comfortable and confident you will become when using it. Hope you enjoyed my lesson today. Don't forget to subscribe and share this lesson with your friends. See you next time. Bye-bye.